everyone. This is Karen.
Hello, everybody. I am Shane.
Today, we're looking at part one of our story, and it's called
Federigo's Falcon.
And the vocabulary words are means.
Means.
She doesn't have the means to keep spending money so carelessly.
Poverty.
Poverty.
Hundreds of millions of people around the world live in poverty.
Wealthy.
Wealthy.
The Smiths live in a wealthy neighborhood.
Countryside.
Countryside.
We rode our bicycles through the countryside.
Arrange.
Arrange.
The company arranged for a car to pick me up from the airport. The company's so nice.
So is this a Falcon story or a love story?
I would say it's a love story.
Oh, okay. A love story that one of the main characters is a Falcon. So who's in love with who?
Okay, so there's this guy named Federigo.
Yeah.
And he really loves this girl named Giovanna.
Ah.
So he is trying to impress her.
So he's spending lots of money, right?
Well, I think he spent money that he didn't really have. So
I like doing this.
This is all cash.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so I think he spent money that he didn't really have. He wanted to impress Giovanna. So basically, he ran out of money. He had no more.
So now he's broke.
That's right.
No money. So he has to move out of the city and move to the countryside.
That's right.
Go live on a farm.
But luckily, I think his only source of joy was his falcon.
Ah, so this is where the falcon comes in. I heard it's a very impressive falcon.
It's like
it's awesome.
One of the best in the
best
world.
Best falcon ever.
That's right. So what happened to Giovanna? She ended up marrying a wealthy guy, and they had a son together.
Oh, but that guy died.
That's right. He got sick and he died.
So she has to go to the countryside.
That's right. She had to go to the countryside to kind of grieve, you know.
And her son becomes friends with Federigo and also loves his falcon. He wishes he could have this falcon.
That's right. And then I think her son also was ill too, got sick.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So
let's find out what happens next.
Okay.
Ooh, I'm so excited.
Interesting story about the falcon.
Federigo's Falcon. Federigo, a young man who lived in Florence, fell in love with a lady named Giovanna. Federigo did everything in his power to get her attention and prove his love for her. He went above and beyond his means to win her love, but it was in vain. He ran out of money and was forced to move out of the city to a farm. There he lived in poverty with his beautiful falcon, which was said to be among the best in the world, as his only source of joy.
Today's lesson is called Federigo's Falcon, Part 1. Hello, everyone. My name is Jeff.
My name is Mike. And yes, Federigo's Falcon.
He's got a bird.
He's
an Italian guy. His name is Federigo,
mm-hmm.
which would be the Italian version of, you know, Fred, Frederick.
Okay.
And he's got a bird. It's a falcon. How cool is that?
It's not
now,
a car.
This particular story took place a really long time.
Oh, so it's
a long time ago in Florence, Italy, well before cars existed.
It's a bird.
It's a bird.
It's a bird.
Falcon.
Okay.
It's not a car.
Just want to make sure.
Anyways, let's learn about Federigo. Federigo, a young man who lived in Florence, fell in love with a lady named Giovanna.
Oh, she has the car.
There are no cars.
No cars. No cars. All right. Maybe
and
someone
no one's
has
riding
a horse.
The falcon. It's a small bird, but it can catch
stuff.
It's a good bird of prey.
It was a long time ago. All right. So Federigo falls in love with this lady named Giovanna. We're in the beautiful city of Florence, Italy. Federigo did everything in his power to get her attention and prove his love for her. He was trying to woo her. He was courting her. He was trying to get her to fall in love with him and be his girlfriend or something like that. And when we say he did everything, he did everything. He went above and beyond his means to win her love. But it was in vain. Oh, that's too bad. If something's in vain, it didn't work. But he tried really hard to get her to fall in love. He went above and beyond, way past his means to win her love. Now, this word means is not a very common word, but it's a good word to know. Basically, when someone says, this is within my means, or I can't go beyond my means, We're talking about their ability to pay for something, all right? So means could be your ability, if you can do something, especially though if you can pay for something, if you can afford it, if you have enough money to do that thing without, you know, borrowing or going into debt or something like that. For example, she doesn't have the means to keep spending money so carelessly. Her job doesn't pay her that well. She's not from a rich family. She can't continually buy Gucci stuff.
I know what you mean. There you go. That word mean, okay, would be a verb. It's quite common. The word means used as a noun, not so common. Anyways, Federigo, he's trying to woo Giovanna, but he can't afford this, okay? It's beyond his means. So he ran out of money and was forced to move out of the city to a farm.
Wow. He threw away all his money on love and then he had to move back home. The city was too expensive. But at least he had a beautiful bird to keep him company. Yeah, that's what it says there in the country. He lived in poverty with his beautiful falcon, which was said to be among the best in the world as his only source of joy.
Anyways, he lived in poverty. If you live in poverty, you're poor. You're barely surviving, barely getting by. For example, hundreds of millions of people around the world live in poverty. They might not have enough money for food or shelter and stuff like that. They are poor. They're definitely needy. All right, folks, with that, it's time for us to take a short break, but don't go away. We'll be right back after this.
Hello, 大家好，我是 Hanny。这一次要读的故事是 Federigo's Falcon， 费德里哥的隼。那么 Falcon 就是隼或者是猎鹰，它是一种猛禽。那我们可以用 bird of prey 来表达猛禽或者是掠食的那种肉食性鸟类。那么其中的 prey P-R-E-Y 它就有猎物的意思。好，那么故事的主角 Federigo 他是一名住在佛罗伦斯的年轻人，他爱上一位叫做 Giovanna 的女子，然后竭尽全力的追求她。好，那么这时候老师们有用到 woo 还有 court 这两个动词。 woo 是拼作 W-O-O， 那么 court 是拼作 C-O-U-R-T， 这两个动词都可以表达追求、求爱的意思。好，那么 Federigo 为了要赢得对方的爱，不惜倾家荡产，但却徒劳无功，最后只好离开城市，搬到农场，都没钱了嘛。那么在那边呢，他跟他美丽的隼过着穷困的生活。他的隼据说是世界上数一数二的哦。那只隼是他唯一快乐的来源。我们先来看两个单字 ，means。Means 当名词，它表示收入、财富。那么 go above and beyond his means 就表达说超出他的财力负荷，使他倾家荡产。那么 poverty 它表示穷困、贫穷。这个字是不可数名词哦。我们说 live in poverty 就表示生活贫困。好，那么生活贫困的时候，可能日子几乎都过不下去了。这时候 Jeff 老师他用到片语 get by， get by 可以表达勉强维持、过得去、应付得来。好，那么课文他写到说 There he lived in poverty with his beautiful falcon which was said to be 怎么样怎么样。这边有两个重点。好，首先句子里面的 which 它是用来代指前方的先行词 his beautiful falcon。那我们来学习这样的用法。好，关系代名词 which 可以引导关系子句去补充说明前面的事物，也就是它的先行词。那么当这个先行词是明确特定的事物时，要用非限定用法。which 所引导的关系子句呢，要用逗号跟主要子句隔开。例如 ，Wayne's new car, which he bought last month, cost him a lot of money. Wayne 的新车花了他很多钱，那辆车是他上个月买的。那例句里面先行词就是 Wayne's new car， 韦恩的新车，它是特定明确的事物，不用限定它的范围，所以我们用非限定用法。那这时候关系子句 which he bought last month， 前后都要加逗号，那去用来补充说那辆车是他上个月买的。第二个重点，be said to 加原形动词，它表示据说怎么样怎么样。例如 ，The castle is said to be haunted。据说啊，那座城堡闹鬼。好，接回课文中。
Federigo's Falcon. Giovanna married a wealthy man in the city, and they had a son. When her husband became ill and died, Giovanna and her son moved to their countryside estate to grieve his death.Their estate was close to Federigo's farm, and Giovanna's son became friends with Federigo. He loved watching the falcon fly and dreamed of owning it.
Okay, Federigo, he tried to woo Giovanna, but he failed. Okay, he just didn't have the money. Now next, Giovanna, we learn, married a wealthy man in the city,And they had a son. So there you go. Federigo, well, he didn't have the means. This other guy, he was wealthy, so he won Giovanna's heart.
Yeah, if you're wealthy, then you definitely do have the means to live a high-class luxury lifestyle because it means you're rich. That's what wealthy means. A wealthy person is a rich person. They got a lot of money in the bank and property and all sorts of other stuff. But basically, they're not worried about money because they have a lot of it. They're wealthy. For example, the Smiths live in a wealthy neighborhood. All right, let's get back to Giovanna and her wealthy husband.Well, he might have been wealthy, but he wasn't healthy. It says, when her husband became ill and died, Giovanna and her son moved to their countryside estate to grieve his death.
So the wealthy guy, he died.
Yeah, the rich guy died, and Giovanna and her son, the son that she and her husband had before he died, well, they moved out of the city too, but not for the same reason as Federigo, not because they were poor, but to grieve his death.
So they moved out of the city there and to the countryside. Mm-hmm. That's where Federigo lives. Maybe he and Giovanna will cross paths once again.
Spoiler alert.
It makes sense. They are living together there in the countryside outside of Florence. So, let's say you move out of the city and you move into the country. You're moving to the countryside. You're no longer living in a city. Maybe you live in a farm and the nearest city's a small village or something like that. One way or another, if you live out in the country, in the countryside, you are living in nature, usually far away from civilization, big cities, and stuff like that. For example, we rode our bicycles through the countryside. Anyways, like I said before, they're all out there now in the countryside, and get this. Their estate, Giovanna's and her son's estate, was close to Federigo's farm, and Giovanna's son became friends with Federigo.
Oh, very, very interesting. So the son made a new friend out in the countryside who just happened to be Federigo. And what was it that brought these two together? The falcon. They bonded over Federigo's wonderful falcon. He loved watching the falcon fly and dreamed of owning it. Here we know that the he is Giovanna's son because, of course, dreaming of owning it. Federigo wouldn't dream. He does own it. But this young boy just loved this falcon, thought it was so cool, and kind of thought, one day, I would like to own that falcon. Will he own it? We'll find out after the break.
好，那名女子 Giovanna 她嫁给城里面一个有钱人，他们生了一个儿子。好，那在她丈夫生病过世的时候， Giovanna 和儿子搬到他们乡下的庄园来为丈夫的死哀悼。我们先来看两个单字， wealthy， wealthy 它是形容富有的、有钱的。好，那么有钱人也许他们生活方式会比较奢侈。我们顺便补充一下 ，lifestyle， lifestyle 就可以指生活方式，是当名词用。好，再来看 countryside， countryside 是指乡下、乡间。那么刚刚 Jeff 老师说 ，Giovanna 和 Federigo 现在都在乡下，他们搞不好会重逢哦。那 cross paths with somebody 就可以用来表达说 偶然与某人相逢。那这时候 Mike 老师就开玩笑说，有雷渗入，他叫 Jeff 老师不要剧透啊。那老师说的 spoiler alert 就是指有雷渗入。那么其中的 spoiler 它是拼作 S-P-O-I-L-E-R， 这个字就可以表达剧透爆雷。好，故事接着写到 Giovanna 他们的庄园呢靠近 Federico 的农场，那他的儿子就跟 Federico 变成朋友了。儿子很喜欢看着那一只隼飞翔，梦想着希望有一天可以拥有它。那我们接回课文中。
Federigo's falcon. When the boy also fell ill, the worried Giovanna asked him if there was anything that could cheer him up.
Mother, if you can arrange for me to have Federico's falcon, I think I would be well very soon.
He answered.
Okay, so we've got Giovanna and her son. They've moved out to the country. They live next to Federico. What a coincidence. And the boy and Federico, they strike up a friendship together. And you know what? The boy just loves Federico's falcon. This must have been a fantastic falcon. Anyways, we've got bad news about this boy, Giovanna's son.He apparently falls ill, and when the boy also fell ill, remember his father also fell ill, the worried Giovanna asked him if there was anything that could cheer him up. Yes, we're wealthy, so if there's anything that can make you feel better, I'll get it for you. Tell me what it is.
Well, like any mom, she just wants to do anything to help her sick child.Even if she can't make him better, she can at least lift his spirits. What would you like? A new toy? A new this? Tell me. I'll get it. Well, mother, if you can arrange for me to have Federico's falcon, I think I would be well very soon. He probably said, mother, if you could arrange for me to have Federico's... He's sick. If you could arrange for me to have Federico's falcon, I think I would be well very soon, he answered. So basically he said...If you want to cheer me up, Mom, you don't have to get me a new toy or a new, you know, Game Boy or whatever. Get me a falcon. I want Federico's hunting bird to sit next to me in my bedroom, and then I will be in a much better, happier mood. If you can arrange this for me, it would be wonderful. To arrange is basically to organize something, to plan something, to work out all the details so that it works well, it goes very smoothly, and you think of everything. For example, the company arranged for a car to pick me up from the airport. They called this car company, gave them my name and the time, and paid them the money. They planned it all, they organized it all. That's it for today!Oh, man.
There's another day. Okay, we'll be reading from part two next time.
Okay.
See you then. Bye-bye for now.
后来 Giovanna 的儿子也病倒了。他就问儿子说，有没有什么事情可以让他开心起来？儿子回答说，如果可以安排让他得到 Federico 的那一只隼，他认为自己很快就会好起来了。好，那么单字 arrange。Arrange 这个动词就表示安排、准备。那刚刚 Mike 老师说，那只隼可以让男孩开心起来。这时候老师用到 lift somebody's spirits， 就是指说使某人开心，提振某人的兴致。那我们最后来看三个重点。第一个是 fall， 在这边是当连缀动词，表达说变成某种状态。那么后面常常会接形容词来当补语用，像 fall sick， fall asleep。Fall silent 等等都是这样的用法。例如 ，Henry fell ill after he ate some raw oysters. Henry 他吃了一些生蚝之后觉得不舒服。好，那么第二个重点 ，if 可以引导名词子句来当受词或是补语用，去表达是否怎么样怎么样。那么 if 可以用 whether 来替换。例如。I don't know if Brad has free time this week. 也可以说 I don't know whether Brad has free time this week. 我不知道 Brad 这个礼拜是不是有空。第三个重点片语动词 cheer somebody up， 它表示让某人高兴起来、振作起来。像是 When Charlie Brown is feeling down, his dog Snoopy is always there to cheer him up.当查理布朗心情低落的时候，他的狗狗史努比总是在他身旁为他加油打气，让他振作起来。好，那么以上的讲解，同学们别走开，马上回来哦。
Hello, 各位同学大家好，我是季安老师，我们今天带大家看简短对话 Short Conversations。 好，首先呢，我们看到这是这个部分的对话架构、哦、那这个考题里面呢，有时候是两个人对话，有时候是三个人，那它的架构长得这个样子、哦、就是呢，第一个讲者他会问问题， OK， 那问问题之后就要有人回答嘛，对不对？第二个这件事情就是回答，那回答之后不是就没事了，他有时候还会继续评论， OK， 他的回答，那评论完之后就我还是有问题，继续问下去，那第二个讲者再回答， OK， 所以这是一种架构。那再来呢，可能也会就是第一个讲者他问了问题之后，他回答，第二个人回答之后紧接着问问题，然后呢问问题就有问就有答嘛，对不对？那答完之后呢再评论他回答的内容，这是第二种架构。那现在呢，有一些考题它是会有三个人对话，那三个人对话呢有些人会觉得很恐怖，为什么？因为他觉得说两个人都无法掌握了，那三个人会不会变得更加的困难？那其实不会啊，因为呢，如果你两个人听不懂，那三个人也是听不懂，四个人也是听不懂，那如果你两个人听得懂，三个人也是听得懂，所以呢，不管几个人，其实对于理解程度不会有太大的差异哦。好，那第三个人对话，因为这个是比较不常见的，是不是？一般都是两人对话嘛，所以有第三人对话的时候，第三个人开口的时候，通常就是会有考题哦，就是考点出现的，不然他干嘛吭声呢？是不是？好，所以呢，第一个讲者讲完之后呢，第二个针对他的陈述去提问，然后回应，那再来呢，第一个或第二个讲者他会问说，哎，那你觉得怎么样 ？OK， 保洁你怎么看？对不对？他要问一下第三个人的意见，那最后呢，再给一个回应。OK， 好，那作答流程的部分呢，我们之前有稍微说过了嘛，就是前四个，在音档还没有播出来之前，我们必须要快速的浏览题目，还有它的选项，好，然后呢，再来就是要辨识可以马上作答的题目，那通常就是这些细节题，因为细节题你没有马上作答的话呢，再拖久一点你就会忘记了。那接下来呢，你要快速的去复查，就是看看所有的选项O 不 OK， 也就是说你选了 A， 那你也要看一下 BCD 是不是都错 OK， 所以这是一个 double check 的动作。最后一个，你要预览下一道题组，这是一个启动好的循环，这我们在之前就跟各位提过了，再让大家提醒一下。除了这四个之外呢，这边还有三个要点跟大家讲一下，就是说第一个，我们在听对话的时候眼睛要看着问题，然后呢看着答案选项，因为很多人在听听力的时候眼睛会闭上，然后就觉得好像这样比较专注，的确没错，可是呢，你不能只有全部把眼睛闭上，因为很多时候你就会遗漏掉非常多的细节哦。所以请大家呢，一边听一边评估答案选项，眼睛盯着这些选项 ，OK？ 那再来第六个点哦，在对话当中你听到的字，如果出现在选项当中，要特别特别注意，因为这个是属于最常见的 common distractor。在考题呢一开始变难，或者是速度开始变快的时候，可能你没有办法抓到全部的意思，那你就抓到片面的一两个字，那人的心理就是这样，你觉得哎，这两个字我有听到，那你又看到在选项当中出现，你就很想去选 OK。 那这种考题在设计的人啊，他通常就是抓着这个大家的心理哦的这个弱点，然后就用这样去出，所以你要特别注意哦。通常哦，这种答案会用同义词或者是换句话说的方式来呈现，它不会一模一样的字 OK， 在听力里面听到，然后在选项里面也出现，通常不会这个样子。但我讲的是通常，我没有讲 always， 为什么呢？因为如果像是班机号码啊、哦，比如说是车次啦等等的这些呢，它你只能就是照原来的嘛，或者是说衣服的颜色啊、衣服的尺寸等等都是这样。好的，那最后一个呢，就是你如果不确定答案的话怎么办？就赶快猜啊、哦，填上答案。因为呢，这种考试它是不会有这个倒扣的，所以呢就把它给填上去吧。All right， 好，那我们就来看一下一个练习。OK， 那在开始之前，我们先看一下这三个题目啊。Where does the conversation most likely take place? 可能是在哪边出现的？好，你看一下，这边有很多关键字，对不对？有 airport security check， 有什么 airplane before takeoff， 然后 airline counter in the airport and a taxi to the airport， 所以你就知道这个应该就是在机场，只是呢，这边全部都是细节，所以呢，机场的哪里，对不对？这个就是等一下我们要注意听的。 Which flight is the woman going to take?他要搭哪一个？然后你看到这边，有什么 Dubai Dublin. Okay, 那 flight 其他都一样，325-33153。那差别可能就在前面第一个 ，OK， 第一个这个英文字母，所以等一下听的时候特别注意一下。第三题 ，How many bags does the woman check in？ OK， 她有多少件行李是要托运的？哦，所以等一下注意一下。OK， 好，那抓到这个重点之后，我们就直接开始吧。
Hello, ma'am. How can I help you today?
I'd like to check in, please. Flight K3153 to Dublin.
Do you have any luggage to check in?
Just this one. My luggage will be checked through to my final destination, right?
听到这边呢，就不需要去继续往下了，因为呢，他已经把他全部东西都讲完了嘛，对不对？好，所以呢，你看到 where does the conversation most likely take place？ 一听就知道是什么，在哪里，在 check in 的时候，对不对？所以呢，答案是 C 哦，at an airline counter.In the airport, OK. 再来第二个是这一个嘛，我们听到一个是 K， 好，然后第三个是什么？就是 B， 好，它只有一件行李要 check in。好，那我们再听一次。
How can I help you today?
I'd like to check in, please. Flight K3153 to Dublin.
Do you have any luggage to check in?
有没有听到 K？ 有，对不对？好，所以呢，这边第二个是 C， 第二个是 B。
In?
Just this one, my...
Just this one, OK? 好，所以这边应该大家都有抓到，对不对？ How can I help you today? 还不知道，但是他是不是 I'd like to check in, please? 他说他要 check in, 然后再加上我们刚刚看到第一题的选项，全部都是跟机场有关的。哦，那这边答案就出来了嘛。所以这是一个 check-in counter, 他在登机的柜台，而且是 flight K, 听到这个 K, 好，所以呢，答案刚刚就是第二个 B 嘛。好，然后他最后他说 just this one,OK， 所以这样呢，应该就非常清楚了。我是季安老师，我们下堂课见，拜拜。
See you next time.